spoiled for choice, with so many options to choose from. Sometimes picking a new anime to watch can be a bit of a burden. Cruising the Crunchy catalog is here to help you lighten that load. Each week we provide additional info and cultural context for a title in Crunchyroll's catalog in order to help anime fans decide whether or not they'd like to give it a try. What's my mental choices are completely interfering with my school romantic comedy. My mental choices are completely interfering with my school romantic comedy as a 2013 TV anime with direction by Takayuki Inagaki, First Love Monster, and animation by Diomeda Girlish Number. It is based on the light novel series written by Takeru Kaskabe, illustrated by Yuki Wo, and published in Japan by Kadokawa, shortened under the Kadokawa Sneaker Bunko imprint. Crunchyroll describes the story of My Mental Choices as follows. Kaneda Makusa, a boy cursed with a mental power who will turn any multiple choice quiz he thinks about into a reality. However, one day in school, he is given another choice. A beautiful girl will fall before him, or he will fall from the rooftop in female clothes. Although he chooses the first option and it comes true, he and his new chosen love, Chocolate, are in for a hilarious multiple choice adventure. This description omits a few key details. When Kaneda is confronted by an absolute choice, he is compelled to respond by picking one of the two options listed. If he stalls or hesitates, he suffers excruciating pain, and generally speaking, all of the choices presented are discomforting, embarrassing, or just plain weird. He's also unable to communicate his plight to the rest of the world. Horror and hilarity are a matter of perspective. If it weren't played for laughs, the central premise of My Mental Choices could be that of a serious drama about mental illness or a cosmic horror film about existential dread in a deterministic universe. Kaneda has no control over when or how an absolute choice will intrude upon his life, and as a result of his literally God-given curse, his peers treat him like a lunatic and a pervert. Punishing puns and random references. While much of the humor in My Mental Choices involves wallowing in the main character's suffering, schadenfreude isn't the only comedic tool at the series' disposal. My Mental Choices also revels in wordplay, with some verbal gags containing as many as three or four puns in rapid succession. Visual references to other anime, such as Initial D and Glass Mask, are also sprinkled throughout the show. Dirty jokes for all sorts of folks. Kadokawa Sneaker Bunko aims at a primarily young, male audience, and as a result My Mental Choices is filled with fan service and sexual humor. Chocolate, for example, is supposed to be an angelic helper sent from heaven to help Kaneda to alleviate his curse, but she's also a relentless fujoshi who expends a lot of mental effort imagining pairing Kaneda up with other guys. The meticulously animated opening sequence featuring all of the ladies in the cast doing handstands should also give you an idea of the tone that My Mental Choices aims to convey. Choose your own adventure. Crunchyroll currently streams My Mental Choices are completely interfering with my school romantic comedy in 93 territories worldwide, including the United States, Canada, Brazil, the United Kingdom, France, Spain, Germany, and South Africa. The series is available in the original Japanese language with subtitles in English, Spanish, Latin American Spanish, French, Portuguese, and German. My Mental Choices are completely interfering with my school romantic comedy is also released on home video in North America by Sentai Filmworks and in Australia by Madman Entertainment. Because of its unusual premise, karmic irreverence, and sometimes mean-spirited humor, My Mental Choices are completely interfering with my school romantic comedy may not appeal to all viewers, but if you're in the mood for a harem light novel adaptation with a main character who actually wants to be a good person despite the interference of deities in his daily life, please consider giving My Mental Choices a try. Special thanks go to resident Wishmaster Baldwin A. Saintless at Baldwin Saint for suggesting the subject for this week's episode of Cruising the Crunchy Catalog. Is there a series in Crunchyroll's catalog that you think needs some more love and attention? Please send in your suggestions via email to emailprotected or post a tweet to @goobizilla. Your pick could inspire the next installment of Cruising the Crunchy Catalog. Paul Chapman is the host of the greatest movie ever. Podcast and GME. Anime Fun Time.